Methode, the overall aim of safety is the protection of humans, the environmental safety, and in first line, efficient operation as a in result of safe and reliable operation. The question there should be, how do a metering guy can assist anyone in the safety? And I say, since a couple of time, like my predecessors already said, the maritime business is bound to an enormous degree of attention to environmental requirements, same as operational requirements. The eyes on the spot of the seamen on board are not enough anymore today, and not sufficient any longer, and can't achieve these requests which are given. One must have solutions for management which are eliminating at last, or at least the human factor on board as we see, as we see it. And these safety tasks are leading, from our understanding, to a clear path to obtain and operate a vessel in an environmental safe and thereby also efficient condition. And knowing your operation, of course, it's, I have one too far. Knowing your operation, there's one missing. Fuck. Knowing one of your operation is the clear path to understand what's happening on board. We built up a flight of four stairs. We built up a flight of four stairs in which the first stage is also a measuring, is always measuring. So you need to have the basic data. If you don't have them precisely enough, you can't go efficient, and if you can't go efficient, it means you can't go environmental safe. The second stage is analyzing or learning from the measured. Once you started with an accurate measurement, and you go to compare these measurements like shaft power data and consumption data to each other, and you're going to combine these data with vessel additional data, this combination already leads you to a way of efficient operation of the vessel. And by efficient, it is also always protecting the environmental safety, meaning the less you are going to consume, the less there is an emission. The better is the propulsion, the lesser losses you have. The third stage is acting on the learned or on the analyzed, meaning we are going to have to do decisions made of the learned and analyzed values, and of course the safe acting, and as we categorize it, without the human tendency to failures, say it this way. Meaning, for example, no SOx pollution in ECA areas or in port state areas. And of course, again, minimizing the human error by automated treatment or management systems. And the fourth stage, of course, is the access of all the data to optimize the voyages, to optimize the vessel's operation and to get an efficient operation. And again, like I said, with an efficient operation, also an environmental friendly operation. And to compare and to observe and to maintain within your whole fleet an high level of efficiency means you are going safely or environmental safety with the whole fleet. So, of course, Aquametro is known to supply one with all the parts we think of being necessary for improving the ship's performance, and thereby, of course, for the environmental safety again. We do have the know-how of measurement equipment, we do have the know-how of management equipment, and we do have the know-how of performance equipment. I will just shortly tell you about how our systems support you in efficiency and thereby of our thinking in safety. If, for example, you do not measure accurate in the beginning, like I said on the first stage. If you do not measure accurate, you can't go efficient, because calculate it for yourself. If you go with an average vessel which consumes 4 tons the hour, you have an average of 6,000 hours the day, the year. You do have a consumption of 24,000 tons the year, which makes at a 2% deviation in measurement a loss of 480 tons. 480 tons divided again by these 4 tons means 120 days of inaccuracy, more or less, which is basically nearly the half of the days are not measured accurate. Meaning the more accurate you get, the better it is for you and for the efficiency of the vessel and, of course, for the environmental safety at the end. And there, of course, we can go more accurate than 2%. We have different counters which can go down to 0.3%. Combining these measured values now with all the available data on board and freeing the minds of the operator on board of worrying about these measurements, meaning we have we have all necessary measurement devices as a one-hand delivery, starting again from the flow meter, down, which we connect to GPS, down to trim and healing sensors. And we are going to combine this into performance systems, like we name it FPS. And these systems can be used to obtain a higher efficiency on board, and thereby, of course, higher efficiency. Again, I said it again, I already said it once, higher efficiency means environmental safe, more environmental safe. The next step, like I introduced, is the automized treating units or treatment units, meaning we take the responsibilities out of the hand of the users on board a little bit, of course, and give them advices and help with the treating units, meaning, for example, if you have the diesel switch, which is connected to the GPS, meaning measuring and connecting, the diesel switch knows where to change over or starts the change over process. The homogenizer unit, if it knows which fuel is used, it can start to operate accordingly and work the fuel down to a better quality. The Viscum system acts according to the requirements of the injection for the engine. And, of course, fuel performance systems can give advices in advance and forecasts, which could be something like, of course, the efficiency decreases if you use a better trim of the vessel. The consumption increases if you have disproportionalities, increasing of the speed. So, and any performance, any of these performance systems, which is of help for increasing the environmental safety by increasing the efficiency, must be integrated to the ship system. Because if you just go with some measurements, you do have nothing. So you have to go with the measurement data, with the environmental data. And in this case only, these kind of systems can assist the operator in improving the performance of the vessel. And if you have the knowledge of the measurements, if you have analyzed the measurements, you can start with optimizing the operation and develop also forecasts which are based on typical pattern, which you can see in the measurements and in the analyzation of these measurements. And again, also, these systems are helping to eliminate the human error, so often called human error, meaning we can improve the environmental safety as a result of a well-managed and well-treated fuel system and well-treated vessel by this. And we call this, again, fuel performance system, FPS. Our fuel performance system has built in these 4 steps automatically. So meaning with all its connectabilities, this is basically the system which is going to give the user the support to optimize the vessel, to increase the safety, to increase the efficiency. This meaning FPS can support, a fuel performance system can support from the measuring connection, from flow meters or shaft power generators. It is already analyzing and learning data, meaning it's combining these measured data. It's giving trend analysis and advices about how to act upon mathematical, physical knowledge, which is certified, of course. And it's going down to the management, meaning the head, with an availability of all needed data, not just on board, also on the shore side. So meaning FPS can, for example, create forecasts to prevent inefficient operation, and by preventing inefficient operation, also preventing the operator to run the vessel not environmental safety. So finally, and as a summarization, it is said that within the last few years, an increase of the efficiency was remarkably low, down to not even existing any longer. And like the whole board before me said, there are no major inventions made in the last years, and there are no major inventions to be seen in the future, which go and could increase the efficiency or the environmental footprint of the vessel. Further, all limitations coming from the engine manufacturer or for the engine manufacturer, for example, like the NOx limits, are strongly confine the possibilities of improvements, of efficiency improvements. And in this regard, it is expected that the future developments of increasing the efficiency and thereby the safety are less coming from better hardware, better engines, new type of hardware within the engine, though from aggregation of the available data on board. So and, as we do have these possibilities to collect all the data and to aggregate all this data together, we can give advices about a safe and efficient operation, same as our automated treatment units can help or assist the user in run the vessel in a safe and in an environmental safe and in an efficient way. Okay. Thank you.